Hi you. Today I'm going to teach you a very very easiest chapter in class 9, Social, the Socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. So let's get started. In this chapter we're going to see the first part, which is the age of the social change. It is broadly divided into the liberals, radicals and the conservatives, industrial society and the social change, and the coming of the socialism to Europe, support for socialism. So these are the four topics we are going to cover under this, the main topic, the age of the social change. So let's get started. In previous chapter we already studied about the main or the powerful ideas of freedom, which is nothing but in the French Revolution, about the equality, fraternity and democratic rights, fundamental rights. Those are all the real or the moral of the French Revolution, which we read in the previous chapter. So there it was broadly divided into three estates. First, the clergy, nobles and normal peasants. So it was divided like that. Suddenly the revolution, so they when the actually the Europe it is the French is present in Russia. So when one part of the Russia gets its freedom, like if this is the Russia and you have the France, if this gets freedom, the people here also want the same. When they see the ideas of this area, I'll color it with another pen. When you have this area, so when this area is filled with all these good ideas, the people of the other countries will also ask or protest for the same thing. The same thing happened here also. So suddenly after the revolution, it seemed possible to change this. In many parts of the world, including Europe, Russia, the rights, the individual rights were actually talked, the significance of the the French Revolution, the ideas of the French Revolution was being discussed by the Rajaram Mohan Roy in India. Okay, in India, we had freedom nationalists who talked about the main parts of the French Revolution or the moral of the French Revolution. Okay, that we say that's moral of the French Revolution. So Derozio and Rajaram Mohan Roy, they talked about the post ideas of the revolution in Europe. Then the development started. So not everyone in Europe wanted the transformation. So everyone, like some were poor, some were rich, so not everyone were interested, but some were interested in that. So for example, when you in the class, a king here. So let's say you have a teacher here in a class, you have a teacher. So some have the opinion that I like the teacher. So let's say class, we have a teacher. And for example, this row likes the teacher. This middle row does not like the teacher. Wanted to change the teacher at once. A third row, they wanted the teacher but not. They are like 50-50. Okay? So, the same way in a classroom, it is like, let's say this is gang 1, gang 2, gang 3. The same way here also, this is a classroom. There it was a whole country. The same way the country was divided like that. So each one had their own opinions, different opinions. Each one had their different opinions. Sorry. So there were three like that. There were three strands. The first strand is known as the conservatives. The second strand is known as the liberals. And third, the radicals. So conservatives, liberals and radicals. Here are three strands. So we're going to study about them. The first thing we are going to study about them. Who were liberals, radicals and conservatives? One of the groups which looked change in society were liberals. So they wanted change in society. Yes, everyone wanted change in society. But they put forward that we need to change at once. So there was a group of people who need a change in society. they all were happy with, they all were actually engaged, or they were happy with the idea of liberty. They wanted to tolerate all religions. They wanted all religions, Hindu, Muslim, Christians, everything they wanted. They want to tolerate all the religions. We have different types of Christianity, right? So same way, they want to tolerate all the religions. And so they have given some examples here. We should remember that at this time, European states usually discriminated the favor of one religion to other. So there were two types of churches there, okay? So let's take, this is church one and this is church two. So people actually discriminated church two and they wanted church one. So the liberals didn't like this. They said that all must be followed, all the religions must be followed, okay? Like the Catholic church, and we have so people favored for one type of church and other people favored for another type of church. So there was a quarrel between them. There was a protest. No, they discriminated. So they don't want these things at all. Liberals also opposed the uncontrolled power of the rule. Okay, so the king's rule is there, right? They didn't like the unchecked powers of the monarchy. So they didn't like that also. Then they argued for a representative. They would like a democracy. They argued, and they wanted the safeguard for the rights of an individual. Let's take, there's an individual. Okay, the invading force or any other person of the other country. Let's take, if this is a Russia, and here you have some other country. Then let's just I don't want to name it. Just like they one. So they wanted to conquer this place. They come, they fight, they kill a person. So who is responsible for this? The king is responsible, right? But he is not. He is not responsible because he says it's okay. He doesn't mind, right? So they didn't like this. Okay, they wanted to get the safeguard. Then they wanted the individual rights. The individual must be given the rights and the safeguard. So that's rights as well as the safeguard. Then they also argued the representative and the elected parliament, government. They argued about that, and they also didn't believe in adult franchise, universal adult franchise. Anyone above 18 should vote to say universal adult franchise, but they didn't believe in that. They said that men who had property only must have the right to vote, and they said that women should never vote. Okay, so that was the idea of the liberals. Now, in contrast to liberals, radicals wanted change. They wanted like a sudden change, overnight change they wanted. They supported the women's women should also have the right to vote, and they must be given the same rights as given to a man. So they wanted like that, and they opposed the privileges of great landowners and wealthy factory owners. As you know that when a factory, his input is around 10 crores, okay? So he gains another 20 crores. So in that, 5 crores is spent for all the infrastructure, labor, land, electricity, everything. The rest of the 15 crores goes to him. So what happens? All the work which is being done by the workers, the hard work of the workers, is not being recognized. All the profits which are being used for what? For his purposes, personal purposes. So they didn't like the privileges, and they were actually privileged, right? When a person has more money, he can do anything, no problem. So they didn't like that one, and they were against the private property. What is this private property? Okay, I'll just explain. For example, you have a land here, and this is a land. Again, I'll just tackle. So you have another land here, okay? This part. So this was actually brought by Napoleon also, safeguard against private property. So this was, for example, you save money and buy a property, and because of some cause, someone takes it from you. So that's not nice, right? So they bought in this type of law. But taking this as an advantage, the rich men started to buy most of the land. So let's take you by you use this. They bought around the full land. Let's take this as the full land. They bought the whole land. And they were given rent and the peasants had to pay. No other choice, right? And more, all the money, everything. Then who got the profit? Who is benefited? The peasants or the landowner? The landowner only gets the profit, right? Not the peasant. Thus, they didn't like those type of... they didn't like the concentration of property in one hand or a few, okay? So, that's about the radicals. They wanted a sudden change. They wanted women suffrages, and they opposed liberals, and they opposed the wealthy factory owners and great landowners, because I said, right? Then we had the against the private property. They also didn't like that one. That's about the liberals. Radicals. Then we have the conservatives. Who were conservatives? Conservatives were people who opposed radicals and liberals. So the opposite of them both, okay? After the French Revolution, they saw that, yeah, we must also have a change in our life. So we are actually suffering from all these things. So we must have a change in our life also. After the French Revolution only, they also thought about that, okay? Then various attempts were also done. Then there were various many things were done to do these thing to bring in the ideas of ideas like which took place in before after 19th century at in the French, okay? By 19th century, they also said that the change is inevitable. There must be a change in the society. So, and the changes can only be brought slowly. At a second, you can't bring any change. It takes slow, it takes more time. And they said that change is inevitable. Okay? And they all opposed the ideas of both the liberals and the radicals. Okay? That's about the conservatives. So, each, like, let's take this is the country. So, this part of people had a different idea. This part had a different idea. This part had a different idea. And this part had a different idea. Okay? So, in a country, to bring any change, the first and foremost thing is everyone must be united. Everyone must have the same thought. Then only you can succeed in any work, not only this, right? So this took more time. That was the problem there. Then what happened? Let's see. Industrial society and change. So we will go to the next 1.2. We have 4. We are in the second part. Okay. The industrial, how was the industrial things took place there? And what happened at the time? Okay, we are going to see it. Industrial society and social change. These political trends were sign of new times. So they each one had their own idea. So it was a sign of, yeah, there is going to be some good future. It was a time of profound social and economic changes. There were some social and economic changes as well as that time. So what happened? Let's see. New industries started to set up. There were new industries set up. Let's take this as an industry. Third place. Here one industry, here one industry, here one, here one. Hi. So today, next we come to the next topic, industrial society and social change. So now we already saw that the society was divided into three strands, and each strand had each ideas, different ideas. So, when that time what happened was the same time industry started to come up. There is industry here,
here is an industry, here is an industry, here is an industry. So when industries started to come up, they developed, railways also developed. That is, railways to transport goods, export and import goods. So we need railways, right? So railways also expanded. Then industrialization also brought men, women, children, everyone were made to start come and work. Okay, men, women, children in factories. So as like on every place, all the places we have this problem, right? Men will be paid more, women a bit less, and children really less, right? And unemployment was a particular common problem. So unemployment, like as there was a low demand for workers, the factories, right, they used to for example, there is a factory here, okay, I have a factory, and this factory has 100 workers, okay. So all work, they bring a load of 1000 goods, 1000 kgs of some good, okay, 1000 kgs. So the work which must be done with 500 members would be done by only 100 members. So they decreased the amount of workers, so the pressure was more, right? So if there are 500 members, the work was less, the pressure was less, but it would not be a profit for the factory, right? They would lose money. That's why what did they do? They reduced the number of workers instead of increasing, and they bought in more goods and they forced them to work more. Okay, then the wages were also less. Their housing and sanitation was also a problem, and radicals, liberals were actually searching for solutions. Like, people are suffering, right? They were searching for solutions. Almost all industries were the property of an individual, right? So you have a industry, and it's an individual industry, okay? It has been run by a individual. Liberals and radicals themselves have their own factories, etc. So liberals and radicals are there, right? They also owned their own factories, okay? And this also, when you know that liberals and radicals wanted to change the society, that this, they were like that, okay, right? So if they were good people, people believed that they are good, okay? So they actually encouraged people that you know, that they believed in single person's effort. That is, for example, in a factory you have 100 members, each member puts his own effort, thus the factory could make more profit, right? But the laborers are only must be given the most important place, right? Because of their work, their hard work only, the whole factory could get all the profit. So they thought like that, and they opposed aristocracy, right? That's wrong, right? That's what. Then if freedom individuals were ensured, so they also thought that the freedom must be ensured, okay? Yeah, everything must be ensured. Many working men and women wanted to change these things, all these things. They wanted people to be ensured with freedom. And for example, if any you are living in a country, it's not democratic, you are living in a monarchical country, if the enemy of the country would come and kill someone, if that is you, if you are being killed, the king will not do anything. Then what is the name of being king, right? So they didn't want the same type of king, they wanted to overthrow the monarchy, okay? Then what happened, the rallies, they wanted to make the men and women started to they rallied, and the liberals and the radical groups, right, they also took place in all the rallies. So nationalists, now we come to a new word called as nationalist. Nationalists, liberals and radicals wanted revolutions to put a kind of government to establish the in Europe. So they wanted to establish a new form of government in Europe. So they wanted to overthrow the existing monarchy. Monarchy is nothing but the king's rule. Okay, so they wanted to throw the existing monarchy. They wanted to bring a different type of government. So we'll see what type of government they want. Nationalists talked of revolutions would create new nations. Okay, they want to revolve so that they could bring a new nations where all citizens have equal rights. So nationalists thought that they must have a society where, like a democratic society, all have the equal rights. Okay, now Giuseppe Mazzini is an Italian nationalist who actually achieved in Italy. So he also believed in this nationalist thing, and he was also successful. Okay, so there were people thinking about this in India also. Okay, then comes coming of the socialism in Europe. So socialism, that was nationalism, that was different. Okay, now this is socialism. Socialism is like a group of people who it played a major role in the revolution. Okay, so what happened was in mid 19th century they were a widespread attraction of this socialist group. So their ideas were really good, it seems. So people were attracted by this widespread of attention. Socialists were against private property, and it saw that it was the root of all social evils of the time, right? I said about the what is a private property and how it works, right? So it's a root of all evils. So they opposed private property, and they said that if the property was owned by an individual owns a property, the profits being gained is used for his personal thing. For example, he gets a profit of 15 crores. He will live a lavish life. He will live a royal life. But the condition of the workers will be down only. Okay. So the socialists wanted to change this. Okay. Now, socialists different fusions of visions of future. So different socialists had a different vision of future. They wanted a different idea. They believed in the idea of cooperatives. You know what is a cooperative? You have heard about cooperative sector and those things, right? It's like a group of members who do a work, and for example, you have a dairy, and each person has a cow, two cows. So the milk from the cows would be sent to the dairy. Okay, and the profit earned by the cooperative will be equally shared. Understood? This is only cooperative. Okay, now this idea was put front by Robert Owen tried this one. Okay, the time Robert Owen is a English manufacturer, okay, in Indiana, New Harmony, USA. So he felt that cooperatives would be a good thing, and the socialists felt that if the whole country would follow the same type, and it will be successful. But there, you know, that Robert Owen had a private cooperative. It's not a government cooperative. Socialists wanted governments to encourage cooperatives. That is, they wanted to separate them as cooperatives, and they wanted to encourage them in cooperatives. These cooperatives were associations of people who produced goods together, okay, and divided the profits according to the work done by the members. Whatever work was done by each member, the profits will be shared equally. Okay, now next thing we have are Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels. So these two people there, no, they had their own ideas, the socialists. Okay, they added life to socialist. Okay, Marx argued that an industrial society was a capitalist. What is capitalist? It's a new name, right? Nationalist, socialist, capitalist. We have three new names. Capitalist. Capitalist owned the capital invested in factories. Capital, what do you mean by capital? Capital means money, right? So, money, the capitalist owned the capital invested. So, for example, a person spends around 20 crores on a factory. Okay, when they spend 20 crores on a factory, what will happen? They will only take the 40 crores together, right? So, the capitalist own the capital invested on factories. Whatever investment is made by this capitalist is taken for himself. So the profits are not produced by the profits are produced by the workers. So whatever work, the hard work being done by the workers are only the profits he earned, right? That's also correct, right? Whatever the effort, daily they are working for around 7 hours. They used to increase the 7 hour, this also, working hours. So they worked hard for 7 hours and all the profit was taken by the owner, who is the capitalist, okay, the owner of the factory. Then the condition of the working condition of the people, he might have paid wages, right? That's also right. But the working condition, the condition of the workers didn't increase, like economically or anything, they didn't increase. They were really poor only. So you can make up that the wages were less and they don't have a proper sanitation, everything was like bad. But all the profits were taken by the capitalists. Okay, so Karl Marx said that he must overthrow the capitalist exploitation. So capitalist must be overthrown. Okay, they must start upon rallies. They want to be against this socialist thing. Sorry, the capitalist thing. Okay, they wanted to be against this capitalist. Okay, then conflicts took place. They wanted to make their own conflicts. They must fight against this capitalist. Then only we could have a safer life in a future. Okay, and they also believed that they must be free from the capitalist exploitation, and they must had they must construct a radically socialist society. What did Karl Marx say? They must construct a radically socialist society. Okay, now I'll just give a recap. We studied that here we saw about the industrial working of the people, right? How industrialization took place and what took there. Then the industrialization took made men, women, children to work. They were employed at low wages. This is because of the low demand of workers. Housing and sanitation were a problem. And liberals and radicals were searching for the solutions. And most of the factories were owned by the liberals and radicals. So they thought that they believed in individuals' effort. They opposed the old aristocracy. And they also ensured that everyone is given their own freedom. And they were against the monarchy also. They wanted to overthrow the monarchy. And some nationalists like liberals and radicals wanted to revolve against the kind of government. They want to overthrow the existing monarchies. Now we had a nationalist coming. We have an example of Giuseppe Mazzini. And next we come to the coming of socialism to Europe. So here the socialists were there. They were against the private property because they thought that it is a root of all social evils. Individuals owned property and gave employment, but the condition of the workers didn't increase. So they were not good. So people thought about the cooperatives. We must overthrow the monarchy and we must have cooperatives. That would work good. They thought like that. Okay, so Robert Owen an example, but that's a private cooperative. They want the government to encourage people to start up their own cooperatives. So Louis Blake also wanted the government to encourage the cooperatives and replace the capitalist. They want to replace the capitalist with what? with the cooperatives. Okay, who told this? Louis Blaine. And we have our Karl Marx and the Friedrich, and they said that they argued against this capitalists. They saw that the capitalists are people who invest on factories, and the capital, the money earned, the profits earned, are taken for his own purpose. The condition of workers didn't improve. So this lead to accumulation of private capitalists. So the workers, the Karl Marx said that the workers must start up of rallies to be against the capitalists. Okay, and they wanted to be far away from this capitalist. They wanted to have their own thing. They didn't want them to rule these people. Okay, now people like accumulated to support socialism. Okay, now came the big legend here. What happened? You will get many names here, but it will be a bit tough, but if you understand, it will be easy. Okay, in 1870s, socialist ideas spread all through Europe. Okay, so hey, they said like that, hey, they said like this. The idea spread to 1%, 3%, like that it went on. Okay, so workers in England and Germany begin farming associations to fight for a better living and working conditions. So they started to fight. Karl Marx words, right? England and Germany, they started to fight. They started to form their own associations. They set up funds to help members in times of distress. So you know that people were made to work for low wages. They set up funds so that some people might contribute to improve the working people who are in distress, that is, who are in, don't have money. And they demanded for the reduction of working hours, right? Because they are working like a dog for many hours, right? In Germany, these associations worked closely with the Social Democratic Party. So these associations, right, when the England and Germany, they formed their own associations, right? These associations played a role. They worked closely with the Social Democratic Party. Okay, it's a party in Germany. Okay, it's like a government party in Germany. So there, they worked like that and helped to win the parliamentary seats. Now, people all believed in socialism. One group is being formed. Let's say this is group one. And it has been with the group two, which is the party, Social Democratic Party. So when people all support them, if they come into rule, they would bring the same thing. People would have thought, and they brought in seats in the parliamentary. Okay, and in 1905, socialists and trade unions formed a labor party. They formed their labor party, the socialists. Okay, and what happened was, however, till 1914, socialists never succeeded in forming a government in Europe. Okay, in Europe, they couldn't form a good government. They're represented by strong figures of parliament policies. Their ideas did shape. Okay, so they didn't form a good socialist thing in Europe. Okay, however, till 1914, socialists never succeeding in forming government in Europe, and represented by strong figures of parliamentary policies. So they were in parliament, right? The first thing we saw here, right? They were in parliament. So they brought in strong figures of parliamentary politics. Okay, these ideas did shape the legislation. So the parliamentary policies shaped the legislation. That is, they actually made a legislation so strong. That's what they're saying. But the government continued to be run by the conservatives, liberals and radicals. Even though people formed their own things and their own associations, they negotiated with each other, even though this took place, but the conservatives, liberals and radicals were only the real rulers. They only ruled the whole country. Okay, this is a painting. See how they have painted. Painting of the Paris Commune. Okay, then we have a Russian Revolution. I'll